प्राये न देवमुनयो सविमुक्तिकामा मौनं चरन्ति विजनेन प्रार्थनिष्ठा नैतान विहाय कृपणान् विमुमोक्षेत नान्यं तदस्य शरणं भ्रमतोऽनुपस्ये। श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल to arrest the perverted tide of this material world is the seemingly unpleasant duty of Gauriya Math. To arrest the current perverted tide of this material world is a seemingly unpleasant duty of Gauriya Math. Gauriya Math have some special responsibility. Gauriya Math has some special responsibility to deliver those material, those bonded souls, in a very tactful way, very special way. That's why Prabhupada told, we Gauriya, we must maintain speciality up to our last time. We Gauriya, we must maintain speciality up to our last time. No, even after passing away from material world, when we get place in that permanent seva, there also we have some speciality. That's why Prabhupada telling, we Gauriya, we always have some kind of speciality. We are not like common spiritual organization. We are not. What speciality do you mean? What speciality do you mean? If somebody asking, then Prabhupada telling, speciality regarding Siddhanta, speciality regarding Seva, both. Speciality regarding Siddhanta and speciality regarding Seva. And one very scientific thing is there. If Siddhanta is translated into Seva, Siddhanta can be translated into Seva. Mane Siddhanta and Seva are same. When we find Siddhanta in applied form, we say, oh, it is Seva. It's not like one philosophy. We can memorize and speak in front of audience to get clapping. Not that. So actually, we Gauriya, we have some speciality. We are not like other spiritual organization. This thing we must remember. We should not forget it. We should not forget it. Forever we should remember it. That day I told, we Saraswat Gauriya Sampradaya, we Gauriya Sampradaya, we must keep, we Saraswat Gauriya Sampradaya, we Gauriya Sampradaya, pure Gauriya Sampradaya, we must keep ourselves into the mainstream of Bhaktivinoda Dhara. Always try to put yourself in Bhaktivinoda Dhara. If you deviate slightly, then you can get deviated from this pure devotional line and you can enter into Abhaktivinoda Dhara. Not Bhaktivinoda Dhara, Abhaktivinoda Dhara. It's very dangerous. That is a speciality. Somebody appreciating Prabhupada, telling Prabhupada, within this short time, you are making 64 moths all over the world. I mean, most of them in India. One was in England. So you may say it's a big achievement. Prabhupada, you are making 64 moths within very short time. Prabhupada telling, what you say? What you mean to say? No, I say actually 64 moths you made, Gauriya Math. Prabhupada telling, actually I wanted to make Gauriya Math into the heart of each bonded soul. What do you say? 64 Gauriya Math? We Gauriya, under the guidance of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we want to establish, set Gauriya Math into your heart, everybody's heart. That is our duty. So we are Gauriya preacher. Otherwise we are Sahajiya. Point is that today, as a Nisinga Chaturdashi, first of all, I like to remember this point. Be careful. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was doing manifesting Leela in Purushottam Dham, that time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to go to Gadadhar Pandit in the evening time and say, Gadadhar, I like to hear Bhagavad Katha. And sometimes he used to say, oh, you read Dhruva Charitra. I like to hear Dabhu Charitra. And sometimes, oh, Prahlad Charitra. Prabhu, I already, that day I already recite already. No, again. Very, after 1 or 2 months of very frequently, Prabhupada, oh, I like to hear Prahlad Charitra. Prahlad, why? My Guru Maharaj used to say, why? And Srila Bhaktivala Tritta Goswami also speaking same thing. I am speaking. Why? Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to teach us first 100% inclination like Prahlad Maharaj. We don't want to hear philosophy. We are less interested to hear philosophy from you. We have no time to hear philosophy. We want to hear direct feelings that your Guru Maharaj already inculcated into your heart. We like to share with you what feeling you have. Direct feeling. We want to hear. So, point is that under the guidance of all our Guru Varga, I like to speak that until and unless 100% inclination is not satisfied, even bhajan, actually pure bhajan, actually not starting. Prabhupada telling, actually, until and unless your saranagati is not satisfied, actual bhajan is not started as yet. Actual bhajan you can start when 100% inclination is satisfied, then you can. Pure bhajan means in action. Now we are doing bhajan. We are not doing bhajan? What you say? Would discourage us? No, I am not discouraging you. Actually, point is that we are doing bhajan, but that bhajan is not direct bhajan. It is like bhajan, shadow bhajan. So, under the guidance of pure devotees say, hey, go to the garden and get some flower, I like to worship. Then I go to garden, nice garden, and pluck some flowers and tulsi, then was and give in front of my Guru Maharaj. My Guru Maharaj then started worshipping Nisinga Bhagavan. Okay? Then my bhajan died. Because I give the material into the hands of Gurudev. And it is channelized directly to Krishna. I mean Nisingadev. Because in material state, we cannot have direct connection with the Supreme Lord. In material state, people cannot get in connection with that transcendental world. Be careful. When we are in bonded condition, we can try again and again, but we cannot get in connection with that transcendental world. What to speak about Krishna? So we can touch Krishna. How? How? Vaishnavero avedane Krishna dayamay ehano pamor pati haiven sadai. I told you to read this kirtan. You read? When one pure Vaishnava appeal for me, I pray to Vaishnava, please you look my case. I cannot go ahead in bhajan. Okay. Yes. Then for me, Vaishnava praying to Nisingadev, you look. Actually, he is in bad condition. You should help him. Then, Krishna can take care of me. I mean, Nisingadev can take care of me. This is the procedure. This is the actual procedure. So you see, actual bhajan we can start when we can satisfy 100% saranagati. That is the actual thing. Otherwise we can do bhajan, but indirect bhajan. Actually, point is that all seva items, any seva item, maybe it's money or maybe from flower, fruits, anything. if we give into the hand of my Gurudev, then Gurudev can channelize it directly to Krishna. This is the procedure. This is the actual procedure. And I would like to speak about Srila Prahlad Maharaj, about Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj speaking same thing. Prahlad Maharaj making one nice application, very painful application in front of Nrisimhadev. Nrisimhadev appear, and in front of Nrisimhadev, Prahlad Maharaj appealing, praying. What praying? Prayena deva munayu savi mukti kama maunam charanti vijanena parathanishta naitana vihayo kipanana vimumokshayeko nanyam tadasya saranam bramuta unupase. See how merciful one Vaishnav is. A Vaishnav like to protect even a bird. A Vaishnav like to protect even an insect. Oh! I can give example from Chaitanya Charitamrita. You know, in South India, when Mahaprabhu went to distribute kipa among whole South Indian people, what happens then? One leprosy man, he developed leprosy, severe leprosy. He has whole body leprosy. Then after that, what happens? There is big insect in scat, you know. So when one insect going outside, he just take the insect. Hey, why you are going? You cannot take food outside. You cannot leave. You can die. So you better you stay here. Here you can get some blood, everything. So you see how much mane merciful one Vaishnava is. And that's why he could enjoy the full blessing of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went away. Kurma Vipra. He went away. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went away. After that, he came and asking, where is Prabhu? I heard Prabhu coming here to deliver we all. Deliver us all. But Prabhu gone. Morning time. Gone? He just get faint. He fall down and crying. After that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going long away. Then again, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu come back. Going long away. Very far distance. And again, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu come back. And take him, embrace him, bless him, go. Vanish. All leprosy, everything all vanish. So you see? So you can also catch the attention of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Provided you are in line. Provided you are in line, proper line. You can catch the attention. I can catch the full attention of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by the mercy of my Guru Maharaj. He cannot avoid me. He cannot ignore me. That kind of tenacity, that kind of willpower should be there in you. Otherwise, don't do bhajan. It is there, written in Rasamrita everywhere. There should be willpower. I must meet him. Krishna must give kipa to me. So, today actually, we are very glad to discuss about Srila Prahlad Maharaj, because it is the topic of Nrisimhadev. Prahlad Maharaj's topic means Nrisimhadev. And Nrisimhadev specially give benediction to Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad, anybody thinking about you and me, discussing about you and me, thinking about you and me, I can deliver him. He can readily go out of this material bondage. No bondage can stand in his life. Nrisimhadev told. What Nrisimhadev told? Prahlad, tancha mancha sarana kale kam karma bandhat pramuchyate. Tancha mancha sarana kale karma bandhat pramuchyate. Tancha in Sanskrit, about you, about me, If somebody discuss, then I am bound to make him free from this material bondage. I can cut the bondage, make him free. Main problem is bondage. That's why you cannot do go ahead. So Prahlad Maharaj giving benediction. Tancho mancho sarana kale karma bandhyat pramuchyate. Pramuchyate. If you know Sanskrit grammar, you can dance. Not muchyate. Muchyate means I can make him free. Not that. Pro means special. Speciality there. Special. Pramuchyate. I cannot make him free. Simple. I can make him specially free. Special. So the neighbor Maya can touch him. Karma bandhat pramuchyate. So now is we are very glad, very happy to discuss about Prahlad Maharaj. Now Prahlad Maharaj in front of Nrisimhadev praying, you like to give me benediction? You like to give me kripa? I am already enjoying kripa because your devotee Prahlad Maharaj already, Narad Muni already giving me? Narad ji already blessing me. So Narad ji's kripa means your kripa. So you like to give me kripa? So you will have to do one thing, Prabhu, it is my application. So you will have to distribute kripa among this Osura boys. These Osura boys, they are sitting here. They are all Osura. They are actually Tama and Raja. Osura mean? Tama and Raja, especially Tama and Raja. So you will have to give kripa to them, right? Like Radharani. Don't come to me. You will have to go give distribute kripa among all these people, material people. Radharani, especially. You will have to give kripa. Radharani. So you see, Prahlad Maharaj, how specially he is speaking. So you must give, you like to give kripa? I am already enjoying your kripa because Naraji, your devotee, already giving kripa to me. So your devotee's kripa means your kripa. So what is the specialty to it? So you'll have to do kippa. You will have to distribute kippa to do all those bonded souls. These Osura boys, they are all my friends. You will have to do kippa to them. So you see how much merciful Nrisimhadev. And in Gauriya Vasya, Prabhupada's writing, but actually there, it is Vishwanath Chakravarti also writing in commentary. We can see very sometime we can see some devotee going to some lonely place, very solitary place, so that nobody can disturb me. Oh, I like to do bhajan nice. And Prabhupada become very angry. Why you go to solitary place? You will have to sing all day and night. The day you stop your kirtan, that is your doom's day. Prabhupada speaking. Vaishnav ke Vaishnavi Patishtha Tatekara Nishtha Tahana Kalide Raviverova. You must explain it. You must read in front of everybody. So nice. So if my Patishtha, what you are giving to me, if I am 100% inclined to my Guru Maharaj, all your Patishtha that you are giving to me, I can pass on to my Guru Maharaj. It cannot touch me. Understand? Then actual kirtan I can do. Kirtan mean harikatha kirtan or loudly with kartal, nice kirtan. The day you stop kirtan, that is your doomsday. You can die shortly. Prabhupada told. Never stop kirtan. Do kirtan. Day by day, if you can feel tremendous attraction for kirtan or harikatha, that is the green signal, that is the nice symptom that you are going advanced, you are going going advanced in bhajan. That is the topmost symptom. Like doctor, if you go, doctor, what is it? Oh, doctor, check up your pulse and speaking everything. So that is the symptom. If there is no attraction for kirtan, especially for pure kirtan, Shuddha Siddhanta, then it is 100%. Maybe he is Sahaja, because those Sahaja, they are also doing Kirtan day and night. But the Kirtan cannot touch the heart of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. We Gauriya, our Kirtan should touch the heart of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. That is the speciality with our Kirtan. We are not doing Kirtan or Haikatha to satisfy you, to get some pranami. I am less interested about that. There is a special thing. I am not going to satisfy material people with our Kirtan. I like to set up my target is to satisfy only Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, the Kirtan Vigraha, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Kirtan Vigraha, and Prabhupada also Kirtan Vigraha. No? Kipaya Hari Kirtana Murti Dharam. Then, Prabhupada also, I mean, you should remember, all our pure Guru Varga, they are all Kirtan Vigraha. Because if you have no information about the Kirtan Vigraha of your Guru Path Padma, or Param Guru Path Padma, then you are already deviated from track. If I say that I, by the mercy of Guru Maharaj, I know my Guru Maharaj, that means I can know the Kirtan Sarup of my Guru Maharaj. And then there is a pure Siddhanta. Because I cannot see one Vaishnava, how much tall, how much fat, how much fair complexion. It's not Vaishnava Darshan. If you look through your eyes, you will be cheated. Don't try to see through your eyes. All transcendental thing you will have to see through your ear. I must look. Because this is a procedure in Parampara Dara. I mean, Shabda Brahma can enter into my ear, I mean oral reception, then I can have a feeling, then I can see inside my heart. Yes? That is actual darshan. And material darshan mean? Oh, who is coming here? Bhakti Vallabhati too. I like to see him. Oh, you like to see him. How you can see? Oh, you see. This is a darshan. So by this darshan, we will be cheated. One day, Srila Bhakti Deva to Madhav Goswami Maharaj, very long ago, when he was in home, almost in home. Then he used to come in Mayapur with some friends. He is coming here, he heard about Prabhupada and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh, we like to see. Take darshan of Dham. Then he coming to Mayapur, taking darshan here and there, Radha Kunsamba. Then sitting and looking to, waiting for Vigra to open, screen. After that. Then by chance, by the mercy of Guru Maharaj, Prabhupada was there. What for you have come? We have come here to take darshan of Dham and Vigraha, nice Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh, really? Actually, we cannot see Krishna. We will have to act in such a way so that Krishna becomes interested to see me. I can see Krishna. I need spec to see Krishna. My eyes is out of order. I must go to doctor to set my power and see Krishna. Not that. This is the procedure. So we cannot see Krishna directly. So we can act in such a way so that Krishna became interested to see us. So in school we used to go, master saying, Samal Krishna present. Yes sir. We say in school, present khata, book, presentation book, you know. Daily, all students coming in class, on teacher, saying, you are present, yes sir, I am present. So I can say, yes Krishna, I am present, or you see me. So this way, see, Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj, though eternal associates are Gauranga Mahaprabhu, eternal associates of Prabhupada, but still, they act in such a way so that we bonded soul can have a nice relation. Bhakti Madhava Goswami Maharaj is not a bonded soul. But still, they act in such a way so that we have a nice relation. We can teach, we can learn this way. So you see, Prahlad Maharaj actually praying to Nrisimhadev, you must distribute kripa among these asura wives. Otherwise, you like to give kripa to me. I am already enjoying kripa. So what use? This way, Prahlad Maharaj appealing to Nrisimhadev. Very often it is seen, some devotee they like to say, oh, I like to go to solitary place to do bhajan. Just now I told, Prabhupada become very angry. You like to do solitary bhajan? Why? You must do kirtan. Solitary bhajan, if I explain from Bhagavatam, you can understand what do you mean by solitary bhajan. What do you mean by solitary bhajan? The answer already given by Bhagavan Sri Krishna to Uddhava ji in 11th canto. In 11th canto, Krishna Bhagavan telling, Banam tu sattikam vasam. Rajasam grama uchyate. And tamasam duta sadanam. Man niketanastu nirganam, nirgunam. So what do you mean? Sanskrit slok, very nice. Bhagavan Singh is saying, Prahlad, sattik, with sattik bhava, if I like to stay permanently, what do you mean? Uddhava, you know, to stay with devotees, pure devotees. It is called solitary bhajan. To stay with pure devotees and to have a chance to hear constant harikatha, it is called solitary bhajan. Solitary bhajan means no material thing can touch me. It's called solitary bhajan. With material mind and material body, if you go to forest, even in forest, your material mind can put you in trouble. Because still now we cannot get control over your mind. So with material mind and material body, if you go to forest, solitary place, there also some sort of problem can come inside your heart, which can throw you away from bhajan. Many examples we can get in Bhagavatam, many monarchists, they go to forest and doing bhajan. Sometimes some apsara coming from heaven, dancing, all bhajan gone. So, solitary bhajan means to stay with all pure devotees and to get the chance of hearing harikatha continuously. Understand? This is called solitary bhajan. Banam tu sattikam vasam. Banam tu mean kintu. Banam tu sattikam vasam. Rajasam gramo uchyate. If one material sannyasi, he is in material condition. Actually, sannyasi and material condition is controversy. But at present, is quite natural. Sannyasi is still material condition. We should not give sannyasi to those bonded soul. Bhaktivinoda Thakur repeatedly give warning. We should not allow sannyasi to all bonded soul. If we give, then very shortly there will be a big corruption in your spiritual life. Big corruption like cancer. It is like cancerous disease. It can eat up the vitals of my heart. Oh, problem. Big problem. So, banam tu sattikam vasam. Rajasam grama uchyate. If one sannyasi, he like to stay with all women and all nice and always enjoying this. This Mataji is there cooking nicely, he likes to enjoy nice prasadam. He is not at all sannyasi. I told you to read, go through Jagadananda Prem Vivarta. In Bengal it is written, Bairagi kare sada naam sankirtam, magiya khaiya kare udar varan, Bengali. Jagadananda is the internal associate of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. From childhood, Gauranga Mahaprabhu playing with him, fighting, playing with him. The Jagadananda speaking, one, if you are sannyasi, I mean detached soul, so it is not allowed for you. Bairagi, you should beg allow, I mean madhukari. And as much madhukari you need, you can take and do bhajan. Bairagi kare sada naam sa. And there is a symptom on one detached soul, I mean bairagi, should do sankirtan. He is interested to do kirtan always. Symptom. Good symptom. Bairagi kare sada naam sankirtan. Mangiya khaiya kare udar varan. Always he is interested in Naam Sankirtan. Not like Sahaji. Pure. So you see, if anybody wants to go to solitary bhajan, for them I explain this point. What point? Bhagavan Sri Krishna is explaining what do you mean by solitary bhajan. Banam tu sattikam vasam rajasam grama uchate. A sattik vas means to stay with all devotees, pure devotees, and have the chance to enjoy the chance of hearing Harikatha. And rajasam means to stay in village or in grihastha's house. I can enjoy speaking with women. I can enjoy taking prasadam. They can cook nicely for me. They are women association. Association means not direct, indirect association. One day, One devotee from Santipur is very interested to stay and do bhajan with Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj saying, you like to do bhajan? Yes, I like to do bhajan. How? But I like to do stay with you. When? But sometime I can come to you and do bhajan. I am Banprastha, I already entered. Oh, really? With you, anybody? My wife also come. Your wife and you staying separately or together? No, separately. She is staying there, my staying. Okay, dear. And what about prasadam? Prasadam, my wife actually, she is cooking nicely. And we offer to Krishna and taking prasadam. Today, what you eat? Mung dal. Mung dal means nice dal. Puff. And brinjal. Brinjal, you see? Fry. Brinjal fry. Nicely. And some nice prasadam is there. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, oh my God. Actually from outside it seems you are not with your wife, but you are doing the association of your wife. How? But you are taking nice prasadam, she is cooking. This is one kind of association. So your bhajan, you cannot do bhajan, you go. So this way explained. That doesn't mean all grihastha bhakti, they can leave their wife and go away. Not that. I am not explaining this way. Don't misunderstand me. Actually, when you are married, if your target is same, your target is this, and his target is same, both your target is same, then there is no problem. No material attraction can touch. Because you are doing everything for Krishna, Gurupad Padma. Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he is also doing, there is no problem. Even you can get double power. When you are sitting here, he is sitting here, doing bhajan nicely, then get double power. Because your meditation is touching Krishna and both his double power. Understand what I say? Be careful about it. So, actually, this way, how and when? How we are doing? How and when we are doing bad association? How and when we are doing bad association that we cannot understand? So find the factories. So find the factories. It cannot touch. Asasanga tagai vaishnava char. Chaitanya Charitamrita. Vaishnava etiquette, the vital and first and foremost etiquette is that I should not do any evil association. Evil association means any association I am getting which is giving me negative reaction. Understand? Bad association mean, evil association mean, I am doing some association which is giving me negative power, not positive power. That's called. So in material condition, one devotee cannot understand that I am doing pure association or I am doing mixed association. Maybe in whole day, 24 hours, maybe for 10 minutes I am doing some bad association. Or maybe I am doing 4 hours bad association. And rest 18 hours good association or 20 hours. So this kind of attitude is not at all good. Association means always pure association, all the time, constant pure association. Not that some interruption, not that some interruption is there. Constant bhajan should be there, under the guidance of pure devotees. This is the main thing. Intent control, you can find Brahmaji praying to Krishna. From Brahmaji, praying to Krishna, I like to stay with some devotees, pure devotees. I like to stay with some sthane sthitaha sutigatam tonubhang manovhir. Sthane sthitaha sutigatam. Sthane sthitaha, Vishwanath Chakravarti explaining, sthane sthitaha in Sanskrit, sthane sthitaha means, if I translate into English, approximately it can come up to this point, approximately you can understand, that I can stay in a very nice place, proper, I like to put myself in proper situation. What do you mean by proper situation? Sthane sthitaha sutigatam tonuvang manovi. Mean, sthane sthitaha, I like to put myself in such a place, in proper place, in such a situation, I like to put myself into such a situation so that I can have the chance to hear Harikatha and Kirtan whole day. That is called Brahma saying. Brahma happening. So, Satyikvas. This is called Satyikvas. So, you will have to explain this way. And how this Satyikvas you should do? Sutigatam, hear me. Sutigatam, Sutigatam mean I can keep myself in such a place so that I can Sutigatam. I can have the chance to hear the Sutigatam. And how you can hear Harikatha? Well, I can put all energy in, I can concentrate all my energy. Energy mean some of your energy is distributed. Wastage done by your ear, some energy, vital energy, wastage by your eyes. You are looking here, there to look material thing. Some of your energy is wastage done, gone through your speaking, all rubbish. This way gone. So I like to concentrate all the energy of all different organs, sense organ. I can concentrate all energy and put one place. Sthane sthitaha sutigatam tonu bang manovhi. Tonu mean body. Physically, mentally, and by speech also. My Guru Maharaj also used to say, dekho, those devotees, they are coming and paying dandavat to me. Dandavat Maharaj, dandavat, vanjagal. Guru Maharaj is saying, they are actually not paying dandavat to me. It is the usual habit, like circus people, you see, they are habituated to ball, this, that. They are habituated to pay dandavat Maharaj, yes, speaking. Actually, they are paying prostrated dandavat in front of me. They are also speaking, dandavat Maharaj, manchakalpa darvasya, But mentally near thought they are not doing. Guru Maharaj saying, mentally they are not doing. So when you are mental, when you are not doing mentally, then all physically you are doing, all useless. Understand my point? So physically, mentally and by speech, three way your submission should be satisfied 100%. Brahma also speaking this way. Sutigatam tanubhag manovir. This way. So you see, actually, Prahlad Maharaj in sloka, the sloka with which I started, in beginning I told this sloka, prayena deva munayo savimukti kama. Sometime it is seen, some devotee, they like to do bhajan for personal benefit. They like to go to a solitary place, they like to sit a nice way and do bhajan. They are doing, they like to do bhajan for themselves. But one pure devotee is doing bhajan for the benefit of whole creation. Even Prabhupada giving explanation, even if you are doing kirtan, pure kirtan, if some pure devotee is there doing nice kirtan, pure kirtan, then if there is lizard, cockroach, no? All different kind of insects, and that Sabda Brahma is doing kirtan. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This kirtan can touch this vibration, because science inside, in science it is seen, when I speak something, the sound vibration, ear layer going advanced. Then it is touching cockroach, it is touching lizard, or other insects. They are also benefited. Prahlad Maharaj, in front of Prahlad Maharaj, Nrisimha Bhagavan speaking. And Nrisimha Bhagavan speaking. Prahlad Maharaj saying, please bless, my father has done so many mischievous activities. Oh, very, very cruel he was. But be merciful to him. I am praying to you. Nrisimha Dev Bhagavan laughing. What do you say, Prahlad? Eh? When you are there in his race, when you are there, then 100% benefit is there with him. What to speak about you and your father? All different kind of creatures there around you, they are also delivered. There I can give. Puyante opi ki kota in Sanskrit. Puyante opi ki kota. Kikota, one kind of creature, I mean, is saying. Nishinga is saying, if one kikota is there, still, by your association, because you are chanting always, doing kirtan, crying by name, by name, so this kind of sound vibration touching, is also pure. So what to speak about other? So nice, you see. So Prahlad Maharaj is saying, Nrisimha Bhagavan, in front of Nrisimha Dev, the Prabhu, I am not so cruel, I am not so partial, no partiality is there in me. My mind is open by your mercy. So some devotees, they are going to celebrate bhajan, and they are doing bhajan, oh, for their personal benefit. But one pure devotee is trying for all. So long as one pure devotee is there in this material world, then this earth, I mean, Prithivima, dancing. It is written there in Chaitanya Charitamrita. When Haridas Thakur left this material world, Gaurang Mahaprabhu was speaking. Haridas was a pure jewel in this world. When Haridas gone, then Prithivi Ma shedding tears rolling down her cheeks. oh, Haridas gone. Then I lose my, I'm in luck. My luck is, I'm very unlucky. Haridas gone. And speaking to Samundar, Samundar means sea. Sea, sea. You see, Puri in Puri, in Puri, Purushottam Dham, there is one sea, Bay of Bengal, you say. Eh? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu daily taking bath in Samundar, in sea. Then when Haridas, when Gauranga Mahaprabhu taking Haridas in lap and dancing whole way and going to sea, and in sea put his body in lap and taking water from sea and washing Haridas Thakur. Then speaking, you see, see, you see, see, you see. Now today you are pure by the touch of Haridas Thakur. You see, you are now pure from today. You are big Tirtha. Anybody can take water, sprinkle. It's big Tirtha. Because Haridas, you are washing Haridas. Huh? So you see. So night deep philosophy inside this Baba. Huh? See? So Prahlad Maharaj saying, I am not so partiality. There is no partiality with me. I like to pray for all those bonded souls. You must go Kripa to them. We Gauriya, we have this kind of philosophy in the heart. We should have this kind of feeling. I mean, like Prahlad Maharaj, we should have this kind of feeling inside your heart. We must be compassionate for all. Not for personal benefit, you see. So you see, this way Prahlad Maharaj praying for all Asura wise. Actually, there was big fighting between demigods and those who were demigods and demons. Big fighting, always. In the history of creation, there is always fighting between God and demigods and those demons. Always fighting. Sometimes they defeat them, sometimes they come in a very aggressive mood and defeat them, drive them away from heaven. Go! This way. So someday it happens so, happened so. The Indra Maharaj is helpless now because Boli Maharaj defeat and they go and fly to some other place. Then they are helpless now. This way many times this kind of thing happens. And see, so you see, so this way, many times happens. So now in this case, in 10th canto, first of all, I like to speak one vital point. 7th canto starting, very nice point. I mean, discussion going on between Yudhishthira Maharaj and Narad Ji. First, after that, this topic coming, Omnishing Mede. Follow. So, Yudhishthira Maharaj asking, how those Asura, they are actually, they are getting Kripa. Then Narad Ji explaining the procedure. Narad Ji nicely explaining, you see. Narad Ji speaking, in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj. Actually, Yudhishthira Maharaj, you see, King, Rajan, point is that, Kenuppu payena manaha Krishna niveshayat. Kenuppu payena manaha Krishna niveshayat. It is Sanskrit. How Asura they are enjoying Kripa. Very nice discussion. It will take long time, maybe 7 days, to discuss one by one point. A very rough, very fine sentiment there. So Yudhishthira Maharaj asking, Narad Ji Maharaj saying, you see, Kenuppu payena manaha Krishna niveshayat. Somehow you will have to concentrate your mind onto the lotus feet of Krishna. Somehow? Somehow, if you can concentrate your mind onto the lotus feet of Krishna, Krishna is bound to deliver you. Oh, really? Kongso fighting. We're in a very fighting mood. Whenever Kongso going to take bath, inside water he's saying, oh, he's coming to kill me. When he's moving around in his palace, in front of in pillar made of spatik, clear stone. Oh, he is coming to kill me. And become. Everywhere, every time he is thinking about Krishna. Because forecast was there. One year. So, I am going to be killed by him. So this way, all the time Kamsa, his mind is always concentrated onto the lotus feet of Krishna. Though negative way, but still, he is bound. Oh, he is going to kill me. Where I can go? This way. So, Yudhishthira Maharaj asking, and then Naraji saying, somehow you will have to concentrate your mind onto the lotus feet of Krishna. Then you can be delivered. Then, do you think I am like demon, like Hiranyakashipu, I can attack Nishingadev with one shot? Because it is written there, Siddhanta. In Siddhanta, there somehow you will have to concentrate. What do you mean by somehow? So I like to do bhajan. I like to become a pure devotee. Should I act that way? Like Hiranyakashipu, I can take one sword and attack Nishingadev, I can cut you. So this is written there. So if I like to discuss this point, I will have to discuss long thing for long time. So Vishwanath Chakravarti giving argument. Sanskrit grammar is there, so nice, like one by one argument. So then I can prove that this is not pure devotion. Though it is written that somehow you will have to consider in your mind unto the lotus feet of Krishna, but we devotees, we should think positive way. But those demons, they are thinking negative way. Not only that, for pure devotion, we must think in a very super fine way, transcendental level, so that I can, my activities, and I can touch, everything can, my mood can touch the lotus feet of Krishna. Then Vishwanath Chakravarti was putting argument, then actually Krishna become very happy to fight with those demons. Very happy, because joy be joy was there. Oh, you go there, I like to enjoy this fighting mood. Then I like to fight with Krishna, I like to go to Krishna, like, then, so this way Vishwanath Chakravarti was giving so much argument. So Krishna like to enjoy Bira Rasa, like, you know, Gangaputta Bhishma fighting with Krishna, I mean with Arjun. Krishna like to enjoy the fighting mood. He is a big fighter. Gangaputta Bhishma. So Krishna is fighting mood. But his mood is totally different. Gangaputta Bhishma. And the Hiranyakashipu, their mood is totally different. I can discuss one by comparative statement. Very nice sentiment. Now here point is there. If Krishna is satisfied by fighting, so I also like to do fighting with Krishna. I can take one sword. Vishwanath Chakravarti was saying, no, it should not be your mood, because you like to become a pure devotee. Now question is that if you say to give satisfy to Krishna, if you speak this way, that to satisfy Krishna is a devotion, then why Yashodama, when going away by leaving Krishna, Krishna, you wait, I am going there to save the milk there in oven. Then why Krishna become angry and throw a stone? Then this is not devotion? Then it must, then what do you mean? Vishwanath Chakravarti giving. So, what we can understand, that Krishna is not satisfied with Yashodama because Yashodama not giving enough breast milk to Krishna. So Krishna became angry. So I can think this way, that this is not devotion because Krishna became angry. So what do you mean? This way, one negative and positive, one by one argument I can put in front of you, you can enjoy nicely. Today, actually, Prahlad Maharaj's mood, you see. Prahlad Maharaj actually, when those demigods, they defeat Asura, then they fly here and there. But Hiranyakashipu is so much powerful. It is not possible for demigods to defeat him. So anyway, they are out of heaven, moving here and there. But someday one thing happens, Hiranyakashipu, he wanted to do some astri and prances. He wanted to go to Mandarachal. Mandarachal, you know, one hill, big, big mountain hill. Mandarachal. There Hiranyakashipu settled down his mind to go to Mandarachal and sit there in cave, and he can sit for astri and prances, meditation. Whom? For whom? For Brahma. For a long time he is doing meditation. In the meantime, king is not there in kingdom. So automatically those Asura, they take information. Oh, Hiranyakashipu living kingdom, he is not in kingdom, he is not there in throne, gone for astri and prances in forest. So this is the chance we can attract now and defeat them. So Indra Maharaj with all his full battalion attract, and then they defeat all those Asura. Those Asura flying here and there. They are helpless now because king is not there. Then suddenly one thing happened. Indra Maharaj coming to arrest Koyadhu, the wife of Hiranyakashipu. Arrest. And he wanted to take her away. Abduction, you know. Abduction. He liked to take her away. Then that by that time, Narada Ji coming to Indra, Rajan, what you are doing? You are arresting, Koyadhu. He is the wife of Hiranyakashipu. You should not touch his body. It's not dharma, it's adharma. Then Indra Maharaj speaking, Rishivar, I am not arresting him. I like to keep her with me for some time after he give birth, because she is going to give birth shortly. So he say Asura, this Asura Hiranyakashipu, his child, he must be Asura. So I like to kill that Asura, because she is going to give birth on child. I can kill, then set him free. Oh no! You cannot do it. Why? But he is not Asura. Not Asura. He is a great devotee of Krishna. Great devotee of Bhagavan. Don't. Oh really? Big devotee. He is coming. Hardly. He is going to take birth. Very shortly. Oh, really? Don't touch. Then Indra Maharaj paid dandavat and do circumambulance 7 times, 8 times and go away, leaving Koyadhu. Then Narada Ji praying to Koyadhu, my mother, you come with me and stay in ashram. But anytime somebody can attack you, you are helpless now. Your husband gone. So you can come and do bhajan here in my ashram. Why? Because Narada Ji want to speak some harikatha, and there the child is there in whom, that child can hear the harikatha. It is a usual procedure. If mother is pregnant, if somebody, some pure devotee speaking harikatha, then the impact, the result going to the child, he become great devotee. Nobody knows this secret thing. They don't know. Very pure. So this way, actually what happens? Then Narada Ji keeping Koyadhu with him. He is staying in ashram. And Narada Ji speaking continuous harikatha. Because target is that child is there inside his womb. He is the servant of Anantadev. Anantadev Anushar. So you cannot kill the child, he is a pure devotee. Oh really? Then go. Then Naraji is speaking Harikatha, and Prahlad Maharaj inside mother's womb hearing all Harikatha nicely. So when Kwayadu Mataji praying to Naraji Maharaj, I want to get one benediction from you. What benediction you want, mother? You arrange in such a way situation so that after my husband coming back, I can give birth to my child. Up to that point, I like to keep my child inside my womb. Oh, really? I bless you. So up to that point, the child is there inside womb. Eh? And Hiranyakashipu doing bhajan there. After that, there Brahmaji coming. Brahmaji after coming, Brahmaji cannot find out where who is doing bhajan. I cannot see, because there is one dust, you see, Balmiki actually in Bengali, as well like bookworm, you see, like bookworm, mudworm, all cover. Nobody can see, only you can hear some mantra. Then Brahmaji looking very carefully. Oh, it's coming. The sound coming from this this hip. Then Naraji Maharaj taking some water from his kamandul and spray. Then Hiranyakashipu coming out with friend's body. Otherwise, his all body, structure, everything, all meat, everything, flesh and blood, or eaten by that worm. Nothing there. Only skeleton. And then when Brahmaji giving water, then he become fresh body and praying Dandavat to Brahma. What you want, my child, my son? I want benediction from you so that nobody in this creation can kill me. Nobody, never can kill me. I like to get such a kripa so that nobody. I like to stay forever. And Brahmaji is saying it is not possible because I am also not going to live forever. I am also someday, for a long time, I am going to die. So I cannot give. Oh, you will have to give this benediction. No, I cannot give. Then after Brahma gone, again doing bhajan. So powerful bhajan. Again Brahma kai. Hey, Brahma Singh. You like to get benediction. Without that benediction, you can ask any benediction from me. No, I want that benediction. No, I cannot give. Any other benediction you can give, you can take. I am ready to allow, give you. Oh, then Brahma is an old man. So Hiranyakashipu wanted to make fool of him. He wanted to make fool of him. Okay, if you want to cannot give this kind of benediction, you do one thing. What? You can arrange such a way so that nobody in this creation cannot kill me. Okay, I bless you. And no, by no weapon I can be killed. Okay. No night, no day, no evening, nobody can kill me. Okay, bless you. This way, Hiranyakashipu wanted to make fool of Brahma. Oh, I can take this kind of benediction, but bent way here. Not directly, but this way I can take. I must take this in very extent. Not directly, indirect way. So bless you. Okay. Then Brahma gone. The Hiranyakashipu after getting this kind of benediction become most powerful. He like to big operation. To all demigods, nobody can do yajna, nobody can do astrid pinans. They are very big, very wicked, very, very notorious. Hiranyakashipu started. And if anybody doing worship, hey, what you are worshipping? You must worship me. I'm king. Like Ben Raja. Ben Raja also speaking that. Hey, what you are worshipping? You must worship me. I'm king. You worship me. I can bless you. No god is there. This is the vital symptom of those demigods. They don't like to understand their supreme authority is there. That's why they are demigods. Krishna bhakta bhavet daivo asurastat viparjaya. Krishna Bhakta, Vishnu Bhakta, Bhavet Daiva, Asurastad Viparjaya. Those who have full faith in Supreme Lord, they are actually gods, demigods. And they are, no, they don't believe. Who is there, Krishna? I am all in all. They are actually demons. This is the symptom. This is a symptom of demon. They never like to understand that one supreme authority is there who is controlling the infinity world. You don't like to hear. Oh, who is Krishna? Let him come and fight with me. Huh? I am most powerful in this creation. So, what is the fault with Hiranyakasipu? When Hiranyakasipu wanted to take benediction from Brahma, he couldn't understand that supreme authority is there. I want to make fool of Brahma, but I cannot make fool of Krishna, the Supreme Lord. This way, after getting benediction, fighting with each other, everybody, and this big operation. After that, in this meantime, when he was doing acidity and penance, by that time, Kayadev was there. So, Prahlad Maharaj have had the chance to hear all Harikatha very nicely. So, Prahlad Maharaj from whom could understand that Naraji is my guru. Understand? Naraji is my guru. So, Prahlad Maharaj could understand that Naraji is my guru because he is speaking Harikatha. Who is giving full consciousness to me? He is guru. So, this way you see, when Prahlad Maharaj was sent to Guru Gaya, here you see, this point I clear first, Hiranyakasipu fighting big way. In the meantime, Prahlad Maharaj grown up. I mean, he should be sent to school. Huh? Then Prahlad Maharaj took Hiranyakasipu sending Prahlad Maharaj to school. I mean, Guru Griha. Huh? Their Guru, Sandhya and Marka, they are the two sons of Shukracharya. Shukracharya. Very nice explanation of this word Shukracharya. Time cannot permit. If I speak 6 hours, 10 hours, whole day, still I cannot speak nothing. So nice philosophy. Time is limited. I have to do so many things. So here you see, Prahlad Maharaj was sent to Gurukul, in school. They are giving lesson on economics and politics, everything. But Prahlad Maharaj is less interested about this kind of teaching. Because Prahlad Maharaj already got Bhagavad Dharma Siksha. Prahlad Maharaj already got, received Bhagavad Dharma Siksha. But now Prahlad Maharaj, what to do? His father sending to teachers. They are speaking all rubbish about economical development, economical factors, like political factors, social factor. They are giving lesson because he is a prince. Huh? But Prahlad Maharaj is less interested about this kind of teaching. Prahlad Maharaj. Now one day, Sandhya and Marka, they thought, oh, now we teach for a long time, so we must take this song to Hiranyakasipu, the king, so that king can understand what kind of teaching I am giving to them, giving to Prahlad Maharaj. Then he take the song to Prahlad Maharaj, Hiranyakasipu, taking Prahlad to Hiranyakasipu. The Hiranyakasipu taking the song in lap, giving kiss and blessing. Oh, my son! You speak something good, you learn from your Guru Maharaj. Yes. Eh? Then Prahlad Maharaj said, Prahlad Maharaj speaking so nicely, you see. Prahlad saying, Tat sadhu manne asura varja dehinam sada samud bhigna dhiyam sad grahat hitvata patam grihamanda kupam banam gata yad harimasraye. Sanskrit. Here also I can explain like Prabhupada. What Prahlad Maharaj is saying? But Hiranyakashipu was asking, what you think good? What you think good? What you learn good from your Guru Maharaj? You speak. I like to hear what kind of teaching you got. The Prahlad Maharaj starting speaking the Tatsad manne he asura varja dehinam sada samudbhigna dhiya masad gruhad hitvattu patam grihamanda kupam banam gataha yad harimasrayet. Harimasrayet means vidilinga. Imperative. Harimasrayet. Hiranyakashipu Hiranyakashipu embracing his son. How? What you think good? What kind of lesson you got? There, you know, the child speaking this way. Hiranyakashipu began, oh my God, how he is speaking this way? He is asking, I send my child, my son to you to teach nice way. What kind of teaching you give so that he is speaking all rubbish? He is speaking about Hari Bhakti? Why? Then all those two teachers. Oh, King, we never teach him this way. We don't know how he is speaking this way. We never. Then how he teach? How he is speaking this way? If you are not teaching, his child is staying inside your area, not going outside. So that we can think about a chance he can get to get bad association. How is possible? Please believe us. We never teach him this way. We don't know how he is speaking. Then here this sloka I must explain very shortly. You can laugh. Very nice sloka. Very nice. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. You are asking about what is good. So I think it is good for all Jivatma if they leave this material world, because it is like Cheta Darpana Marjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nirmapam Bhava Mahadavagni Nirmapam. Everywhere there is fire. Mahaprabhu saying, in this material world, everywhere there is fire. All fire, they are fighting with each other. With money, woman, position, rank, all is fighting with it. So everywhere fire, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking. Chetadarpana Mahajanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapanam. So everywhere the whole world set fire. Then Prahlad Maharaj saying, I think this material world, this family life is like fire. They should leave this place and go to a nice place where they can have the chance to do solitary bhajan. Mean, they can have the chance to get the association of pure devotees in Harikatha. Though, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Tat sadhu manne, that I think good for all these material people, because they are always excitement. They are always, they are in deep excitement, always. Oh, maybe I can lose that amount of money. Because share market going down. And maybe he can attack me and take away that amount of money from me. Maybe he can kill me. This way, always in excitement. There is no peaceful attitude. Only you can find peaceful attitude inside the heart of a pure devotee. You can look all everywhere. You can see some sort of tension is there. Everywhere. Each and everywhere throughout the world, you can find everybody is there inside some sort of tension. Oh, tension. So they sometimes develop hypertension, high pressure, sometimes low pressure, sometimes sugar, this way, because they are always in tension. So you see, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Tat sadhu manne asura varja dehinam, for third material people, I think it's good. Tat sadhu manne asura varja dehinam. He is speaking not this way, that, oh father, don't speak father. Prahlad Maharaj not speaking, oh father, not speak this way. Prahlad Maharaj is very clever. Don't speak this way. Because each and every word spoken by Prahlad Maharaj is our big teaching. So Prahlad Maharaj not speaking this way. Oh, Father, this I think good. Not speak. Oh, Asura Varja, a topmost Asura. A topmost Asura. A topmost Asura. I think is good. Topmost Asura means Rajo Tama Guna topmost. You are the oldest personality in this world. You are the worst personality in the world. Prahlad Maharaj speaking so nice dignity, so nice way. And Hiranyakasipu was laughing. Oh, he is giving so much title to me. Oh. But Prahlad Maharaj used to say, you want to say, you are the worst personality. Because Tamagun and Rajagun pull up your heart. But Hiranyakasipu was thinking, oh, my son is so much educated. He is giving big title to me. Tatsadmanne Asuravarja Dehina. Hey Asuravarja Dehina, for a man here, material people, I think it's good if they go to a solitary place and do bhajan. Hari bhajan, if they do, engage that. If they can engage themselves in Hari bhajan, it's good. Hiranyakasipu will become very angry. Oh my God, he's a 5-year child. How he can speak all rubbish? Eh? Then he's speaking all rubbish. Then those two teachers, they become frightened. Okay, let us try again and again. Go away with this child. I don't like to hear all rubbish. They try to give a nice lesson to him. Okay. Okay, please excuse me. Don't become angry. Because if Hiranyakasipu become angry, it is written. If Hiranyakasipu become angry, if he speak this way, I mean, he says his forehead become, then all three world become second. If Hiranyakasipu become very angry, then three world become very frightened. So they go away with the child, then they are going to home. I mean, their school. I mean, they are staying Guru Griha. I mean, this is called Guru Kul. Then they are very secretly asking to Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad, we like to ask one question to you. What question? How you get this kind of teaching? Don't speak lie. If somebody giving you this lesson, who is that? Who is that personality? Who is he? Then Prahlad Maharaj in a very laughing mood. Because the teacher, don't speak lie, Prahlad. We like to hear how you get this kind of teaching. Because we are not teaching you that way. Huh? Our teaching procedure is totally different. How you get? Then Prahlad Maharaj says, nobody in this 14 world can give this kind of teaching. Personally, I cannot get this kind of teaching. Or no material people can getting this kind of teaching. Not possible. Then how? It's absurd. Nobody can cut. Nobody can learn this kind of teaching. No material guru can give this kind of lesson. And personally, I cannot get this only. Very nice sloka. Then after that, मोतीर न किशने परतो शतोबा मीथो विपद्दे तो गिहो व्रतानम आदांत गोभीर विशताम तमिश्रम पुनः पुनः चर्वितो चार्वनानम मोती रिसाइट मोतीर न किशने परतो शतोबा मिथो विपद्दे तो गिहो व्रतानम आदांत गोभीर विशताम तमिश्रम पुनः पुनः चर्वितो चार्वनानम प्रहलाद महाराज सिंह मोतीर न किशने परतो शतोबा नो डायरेक्टली और नो इनडायरेक्टली नोबडी कैन गेट दिस काइंड ऑफ लेसन. It is a matter of luck, super luck. Motirna Krishna Parudusato. Mitho Vipod Dedo Gihapratanam. Those who are in material life, Grihabhata. Grihabhata mean their material conception, material life is there totally inside their brain. There is no vacancy to think about Krishna. No vacancy. Then, how to think? Then after that, Prahlad Maharaj saying, Motir na Krishna paruto sotoba. Mitho vipadde to grihabhratana. Those who are busy with material conception, their conception cannot transcend this material bhavana, material bhava. They cannot transcend in the world. That's not possible. Odanto, because their sense organ, they are restless. Odanto gaurir vishatam tamishram. Odanto mean all their material sense organ, hand, leg, skin, fine sense organ, fine and five coarse. Pancho karmendriya, pancho ganendriya. All they are busy to enjoy, get rasa enjoyment, material enjoyment. If you are successful in concentrating all your mind and body, all sense organ, if you can see one pointed devotion, all your sense organ, all your mind, everything together with mind. If it is one pointed, then you are successful. Otherwise, you are not successful. Follow. Try to get this kind of achievement. First point. Then after that, Prahlad Maharaj saying that what speaking Prahlad Maharaj, all sense organs they are running here and there. Dhruva Maharaj also. Dhruva Maharaj also speaking this way. When go, Dhruva Maharaj speaking. Hey! Hup! And when Dhruva Maharaj, doing praying prayer, doing a sloka, then Dhruva Maharaj also speaking this way. My hand and leg, my eyes, my ear, my tongue was pulling me. My tongue pulling this way, my ear pulling this way, my eyes pulling this way, leave there. So I am helpless. I can discuss all those points after. So you see, Motir na Krishna paruto satoba mitho vipaddeto grihabhatanam odanto. Odanto ved, because they have no control over their sense organ. They are all material people. Odanto govir vishatam tamishram. With those material sense organ, they are enjoying material thing and gradually they are going down and down and down and down and down to negative void. Vishatam tamishram. Gradually they are going to enter tamaguna, you know? Tama, patatir, in Sanskrit I can say patatir adhor adho. Going down and down and down and down. See, patatir adhora is written. Adanta govir visatam tamishram panaha panaha charivita charvananam. Prahlad Maharaj is thinking, actually, usually I give a nice example. One dog, for long time is not getting any fruit, any food. I mean, fasting for long time. So one day, suddenly he find one dry bone lying in, for a long time that bone is lying. Suddenly he discovered that bone. He thought, it's nice food I get today. He go and collect that bone and a very nice place to sit. He is taking that bone a long time chewing. He thought, I am going to get test out of it. But he don't know, he is very foolish, that dog. By that dry stone, he cut his cheek and blood coming of it. And then he is getting the taste of blood. He thinks it is coming from the dry bone. Oh, so nice. He don't like to leave that bone. Long time he is getting the taste. So this way, all material people, they are getting the enjoyment in material life. Oh, some sort of enjoyment is also there. But they should think it is like that dry stone. punaha punaha charvita charvanam. In our mat, everywhere we make prasadam. Some sort of stick we cook, you know, stick. We speak in sojne data. We speak sojne. In Vrindavan, when I was doing bhajan there, in Suryakunda everywhere, if I collect that stick from, because I go from Madhukuri and Bajavasis, and sometimes I get that stick and come. Baba, what you can do with this stick? I can cook. Oh, cook? We never think about that. Cook? Nice prasadam we can make. they are laughing. Hey, is this trick? What you can cook? Baba lakdi ka sabji kar raha hai. Hindi. They are speaking Hindi. Haan, Baba lakdi ka sabji bana raha hai. Kya hai? Hindi. They are speaking this way. So when you get this kind of prasadam, we chew. Two stick you take, we chew. After you throw. After that, again we take that residue, again we chew. It's not good, because already we have done that rasa coming out. So this way, Prahlad Maharaj giving this Baba, the material people, they are getting the same rasa. They think it is nice rasa, but it is dry rasa. There is no enjoyment, but they think we are getting enjoyment. So Prahlad Maharaj giving argument this way. So after that, you see, again Prahlad Maharaj had done nice thing. When he was there in Gurukul, whenever there is leisure time, I mean when two gurus, you see, Chandu and Amarka, where if they are outside Gurukul, is going outside for marketing there, here and there, that time Prahlad Maharaj is getting time to give class to all the Asura boys. Oh, Asura boys, come and sit. No, actually they used to come. It is written there. All Asura boys, they used to come, living. Actually, those small boys, they like to play. But they leave all playing everything, they don't like to play. They come to Prahlad Maharaj, sit all around and putting question in front of Prahlad. Prahlad, we are taking same lesson with you in same place. But how you get this kind of lesson? You see, we are very astounded. But then you speak something, then Prahlad Maharaj giving nice lesson to those Asura boys. When Sandhya Namarka, two teachers going outside, Prahlad Maharaj have the chance to speak Harikatha nicely. Big preaching. Big preaching. Prahlad Maharaj speaking big preaching. Nice preaching. So much nice preaching Prahlad Maharaj doing. Those small boys, they are motivated. Fully motivated. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, you see, you are all busy with material enjoyment. But you know, Krishna is everywhere. Krishna is present everywhere. You are taking trouble to do or to worship this and that. But Krishna is everywhere. You can do bhajan anytime, anywhere. And there is no trouble for Krishna bhajan. Krishna bhajan is very easy. Prahlad Maharaj saying Krishna bhajan is very easy. You need not run here and there. Krishna is already there inside you. It's only you sit and do bhajan. Krishna is there inside you. So you need not go and here and there run. Krishna is there inside you. You just settle down your mind and under the guidance of Gurudev, start bhajan right now. Prahlad Maharaj saying, very easy. All your sense organ, everything is restless. Always you are busy with material enjoyment. But be careful. It is the kind of bondage for you. So Prahlad Maharaj giving nice lesson to those demon boys. Asura Balak. So nice. After that, again Prahlad Maharaj was taken to Hiranyakasipu. So that Hiranyakasipu, I mean the king can understand what kind of lesson we give. Then after that, Hiranyakasipu going to embrace him, that small boy, taking his lap, giving blessing, and then again asking, what lesson you get nice? Anything if you think nice, that lesson you can. Prahlad Maharaj. Then again he is going Navavidha Bhakti, he is speaking. What? The sloka? Savanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Sparanam, Pada, Sevanam. Sab. Whole. Nine folds of Bhakti. And after that last line, Kriyeta Dhyā Tanmanne Adhitamuttamam. You asking me what kind of lesson I learned from my Guruji. Hiranyakasipu's mood is that what kind of lesson Prahlad getting from Sandara Namarka. But Hiranyakasipu anyway, Hiranyakasipu is not specifically speaking anything. Only speaking what you learned from your Guruji. Prahlad Maharaj thought, my Guruji is Prahlad. My Guruji is not Sandara Namarka. So my he is asking this way, what you learned from Guruji. So my Guruji is, actual Guruji is Naradji. So I just speak this way, nothing wrong in it. Sabanam, Kirtanam, Vishnusparanam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Saksham, Atmanivedanam, everything. Nine folds of Bhakti. He is speaking again about Krishna Bhakti. Hiranyakasipu become big disgusted. Oh, rubbish! Again he is speaking about Krishna Bhakti. Why? Then again there's the two teachers they become. We never teach him. And how he is speaking this way? Then those teachers speaking. Your son, he is speaking, naturally he is speaking this way. Naishargi kitu yam matirasarajan. Naishargi kitu yam matirasarajan. Those two teachers they are speaking. Rajan king, don't become angry with us. We never learn. We never give lesson this way. Actually, your boy is quite natural. His nature is like that. Naishargi kitu yam matirasarajan. His nature is like that. We cannot change his nature. His nature is like that, like impression. He's speaking this way. So don't become angry with us. Please. And after that, Hiranyakasipu asking, hey, where from you get this kind of teaching? If you speak, your Guruji, not your Sandara Namarka, these two Gurudev, two Gurujis, not giving this kind of lesson. Where from you get this kind of lesson? He was asking this for the command. And after that, then when Prahlad Maharaj answering in a very nice way, then he became more angry, more and more angry. Then take Prahlad Maharaj and throw, go! From high throne, he throw Prahlad Maharaj, throw! Small boy, so merciless. Throw, he fall down. After that he is asking, you are making us big, you are giving big lecture in front of me, don't fear me, do you know, in front of me all 14 world they are frightened, how dare you speak this way, who is giving you power, to speak this way? Prahlad Maharaj speaking to him. That Supreme Lord who is giving power to you, who is giving power to me, who is giving power to everybody, by that power I am speaking. Stop! Nonsense. I don't like to speak. I don't like to hear. Hiranyakasipu become more and more angry. Oh, rubbish. Prahlad Maharaj speaking nicely. His temperament is very controlled. Supreme Lord, he is giving power to me to speak, he is giving power to you to speak, he is giving power to everybody, that's why everybody, the whole world running and doing and speaking, that is the supreme power. Stop! I don't like to hear. Where is that power? I like to see. That is called demigod, that is called demonic attitude. Demonic attitude means they like to kill supreme power. They like to kill. I must be all in all. That is called demonic attitude. Though no submission is there in the life of the demigod, demons. The main problem is that, Prabhupada saying, the main problem is that the Hiranyakashipu is so foolish. Hiranyakashipu should understand that this five years boy, he is your guru. That 5 years boy, he is your guru. You should understand. But you are so foolish, you cannot understand. You think he is my boy. He is innocent. He is foolish, you think. But you don't know. He is 5 years boy. His name is Prahlad Maharaj. He is your guru. You should accept that 5 years boy as your guru. Then instant you can come out successful in spiritual bhajan. So foolish. You think he is an idiot. Huh? You like to kill him? He is your guru. Prahladma. Prabhupada explained this way. The main fault of Hiranyakashipu is that Hiranyakashipu cannot understand that 5 years boy, this boy is your guru. Heavy guru. Guru means heavy. Heavy guru, no, yeah. Why you think this way? Hiranyakashipu is foolish, actually. Then Hiranyakashipu put his question, where is your, that supreme power? I like to see him. I like to see him. Where he is? Where is the place? He is everywhere. He is staying everywhere. Oh, everywhere? Then how I can find in this column? In this pillar? In this pillar, in this column? I like to see him. He is there? Yes, he is also there in this column, in this stone, in this pillar. Also, my Prabhu, my Bhagavan, Supreme Lord is also there. Yes! And he give a big fist. Doom! Then that pillar will crash. Crash and fall down. Then within that, ha 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 ha, Hiranyakashipu coming out. Hiranyakashipu. He is looking, who is it? What is this? Eh? So power actually, light coming. Impersonal Bombay falls in this because he is Asura. He cannot see. Hiranyakashipu inside that growing, very like sun, you cannot look. So power. After the looking, oh my God, what is this? Half lion, half man. Eh? I never see this kind of creature. Who is that? The Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu like in a very fighting mood. Hey, take one sword and one protector, you see, dal. And jump into that fire and light to cut Nrisimhadeva. Then Nrisimhadeva going here and there like one mouse, snack, sometimes leave that mouse running, again catch, again leave. Again, mouse running, this way the snakes, they are playing. You see? So, Hiranyakashipu sometimes catching, sometimes throw. He is going, very fighting mood, he is attacking mood. Big fighting took place. Hiranyakashipu thought, I must kill. I never see this kind of creature in my life. I am the supreme authority in this world. Who can do anything to me? Who can do any harm? He is a very attacking one. The Hiranyakashipu, he fighting with Nrisimhadeva very nicely. Nrisimhadeva all the playing, sometimes going here and there, he is running, catching him, throwing him. This way, after that, all demigods, they are coming in heaven. Oh God, don't play with this snack. Oh Supreme Lord, don't play with this snack. He's a very poisonous snack. Kill him right now. Because it is the right time. Brahma give benediction. Because no night, no not day. Middle, I mean evening time. So this is the right time. Kill him right now. Please, Prabhu. Then Hiranyakashipu, Nrisimhadeva, what happens? After that, Hiranyakashipu catch him and put in lap. there, and is actually not room, not outside, middle, not room, not inside room, not outside, in the middle. Take him and lap. After that, with nail, cutting it, all blood and everything coming, and this come blood sparking, come here and there. Nrisimhadevi is so nice now looking. Oh, all demigods come and pray. Prabhu, please save that. Please save us. Because it seems that Mahapralaya, total destruction, it seems total destruction. This is not the time of total destruction. So we are very fearful. We are trying to control Prabhu, yourself, as your son. Hiranyakasipu, you have so much love for him. So everybody there, Brahma, Shankar, Indra, Varun, but they don't like to go to Hiranyakasipu. They don't like to go to Nrisimhadev. There's so much they don't get power. Oh, then they all request Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad. For you, Supreme Lord coming in this form. So you must go. Nobody can have that much power to go to in front of Nrisimhadev. Everybody fear. Brahma, Sankarva. Oh, we never see like this. Then they all request Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad, my our son, you must go to your Lord, Supreme Lord coming for you. Prahlad Maharaj fearless. Oh, really? Prahlad Maharaj going straight, very smart. Prahlad Maharaj never fear. Hiranyakasipu there, but Prahlad Maharaj never fear. When Brahma, Shankara, all everybody request, Prahlad, you must go to Prabhu to pacify him. Oh, Prahlad Maharaj going straightly and pray. Prostrated Dandavad in front of Nrisimhadev. Then Nrisimhadev become merciful, full of mercy, melt. He's smart, full of mercy. Then Nrisimhadev taking Prahlad Maharaj from ground and put him back. Oh, yes. Then licking. Like Nrisimhadev, like lion. Hey, lion, mother lion. Licking. Licking his whole body. Giving blessing. Then Nrisimhadev become very peaceful. Prahlad Maharaj giving so much sloka. If I discuss, seventh canto, 1 year full. Still I cannot finish. Whole year I can discuss. The seventh canto. So nice philosophy, you see. So today, we have the chance to do bhajan, because any kind of impediments, any kind of barrier, today we can cut all barrier and throw. Today is the day. So don't waste your every even fraction of second. Don't waste. Do bhajan now, today. Because my Guru Maharaj used to receive Nrisimhadev in such big way. So always Nrisimhadev become very happy with Guru Maharaj. Always. Special. Why? To cut different kind of barriers. He used to beg for us also to Nrisimhadev. This way. So today is the day. We have the chance to cut any kind of barrier. Nrisimha Chaudhusi, if we can do perfectly, then no problem can touch us. No problem can touch us. We can cut our problem. Because bhajan means always problem. Bhajan means in every fraction of second, there can be one and other kind of problem. So what it concerns to me? I don't care. Because I am going to enjoy full kripa from Gurudev and Nrisimhadev Guru Varga. So I don't care. My Guru Maharaj used to speak, Baba, my son, always try to call, Hey Gurudev, Hey Nrisimhadev, Hey Prabhupada. This is the mantra Guru Maharaj used to, you must remember. Guru Maharaj speak to you. You always speak, Hey Gurudev, Hey Nrisimhadev, Hey Prabhupada. This mantra. No problem can touch you. Understand? So this way today, Hiranyakasipu is there inside our heart. Now I like to explain the word Hiranyakasipu. Very carefully you must hear. Hiranyakasipu mean, Hiranya mean gold, I mean all treasure. Hiranyakasipu mean nice bed. Bed mean woman, I mean enjoyment. This way we must cut this guy. Hiranyakasipu is the embodiment, he is the emblem of, he is the full feature. You see, Hiranya and Kasipu is two symptoms. That's why his name is Hiranyakasipu. He don't want to understand anything out of that. So now Hiranyakasipu is there in everybody's heart. In everybody's heart, more or less, Hiranyakasipu is there. So it is our duty to cut, to kill Hiranyakasipu by Nrisimhadev. Oh Nrisimhadev, please kill Hiranyakasipu, make me free, so that my heart becomes so big and pure, so that I can make arrangement for your sitting. Cheta darpana marjanam bhava mahadavagni nirvapanam seyokairava chandika vitaranam vidyavadari jivanam anandan mudhi varadanam patipadam purnamiswa swadanam sarvatma snapanam param vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. Bolo jai Nrisimhadev Bhagwan ki jai, jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai, jai Srila Gurudev ki jai, jai Nrisimha Chaturdashi ki jai, Shapasasi Prahlad Maharaj ki jai, Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. Sravanam Kirtanam Vishnuh Smaranam Padasevanam Archanam Bandhanam Dasyam Saksham Atmanivedanam Iti Pungsar Pita Vishnu Bhaktischet Navalakshana Kriyet Bhagavati Adhyatan Manne Aditamuttamam Tanmanne Aditamuttamam.
Maharaj, what relationship do the Navadvipasis have here with Nrisimhadev?
We think our Nrisimhadev is not Nrisimhadev like other people, Devashi.
Yes.
Our Nrisimhadev is Gaur Nrisimha. Our Nrisimhadev is Gaur Nrisimha. When I pray Puspanjali, I say, Esa Sachandanam Puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Gaur Nrisimha. Nrisimhadev take the form, Gauranga Mahaprabhu take the form of Nrisimha here in Gaur Dham, so we enjoy. So we have extra facility. So you should think this way. Any kind of problem we can cut if Nrisimhadev giving full kippa to us.
It's like Govardhan in Vrindavan. It's like Govardhan in Vrindavan for the Brajavasis.
Yes. Ultimately, we'll have to take the kippa of Nrisimhadev. I mean, Gaur Nrisimha. After that, we can cut all barrier. Kobe ham herabo si Vrindavan like Narottama Thakur. Like Narottama Thakur do kirtan, kobe ham herabo si Vrindavan in kirtan. Ar kobe nitai chander karuna hoibe, bishay vasana mor kobe tuchya hobe. This kirtan you must do. So you are right actually. Through this kripa we can cut all barriers. We can cut all bodily problem, outside problem, mental problem, everything. After that we can be free to do Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan and go to Vrindavan. We, Gauriya, devotee, we have double facility. After passing away from this material world, we can get two body. One body, we can, one feature, one body, Siddha Deha, we can do bhajan in Gaur Dham, another body in Shoki Manjari body in Gauranga Mahaprabhu Gidu station. Very secret thing, I can speak after. So we can do bhajan there in the Dham. Both. We can get entry in two Dhamma, simultaneously. Sarup Siddhi and Vastu Siddhi, two things I can discuss after. First of all, preliminary thing you discuss and try to go out of this material. One chakal patro shikipasan dhubhavashu.